Lord, let there be a transfer of wealth, overturn and overturn, until it comes to the turn of who it belongs to, that the citizens of this nation, the commonwealth of this nation, will be for the benefit of the citizens of this nation. You will eat the good of this land. You'll be a partaker of the blessings of God in this nation. In the mighty name of Jesus, everyone oppressing you, resisting you where you have been planted by God, God will overturn them for you. Lord, we are assured of divine provision and assistance in the name of Jesus. Welcome to the day 24th of our 30 days fasting and prayers. And today we will be praying for divine provision and assistance. Our focus text is taken from Philippians chapter 4 verse 19, and it says, "And my God, your God also shall supply all my needs according to his riches in glory by Christ Jesus." As we pray today in the name of Jesus, every need of our lives will be met. Every resource and every provisions that we need to make our joy full, to make our testimonies complete, as we pray, God will release them into our lives in the name of Jesus. Father, thank you for all your assistance to us as a nation. Thank you for all your assistance to me as a citizen of this nation. Thank you for all that you have done for me, done for my family, done concerning the work of my hands. Father, thank you for your faithfulness to me and my family, to this nation, to us as a people. Lord, we thank you. If not for God who had been on our side, we would have been consumed by now. We would have become history by now. We would have been forgotten by now. Lord, we say thank you. Blessed be your holy name. In Jesus' mighty name we give thanks. Amen. Father, we thank you as a nation of people who trust in you for our supplies. Thank you, Jesus, for your abundant divine supply, for divine resources, for natural resources you have made available to us as a people. Lord, we appreciate you. We give you all the glory. Thanks, thanks, we give you thanks for all you have done, Jesus. We are so blessed, and our souls are found rest in you. Oh Lord, we give you thanks. Lord, our trust have been in you and will continually be in you. Thank you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. You say, Father, please pardon our shortcomings as a nation, particularly the sin of eating what you have not ordained us to eat. Lord, we ask for your mercy and that you will pardon us as a people for the sin of taking what you have not given to us, for the sin of bribery and corruption, for the sin of embezzlement, for the sin of stealing or fraud. Father, have mercy upon us as a people. Lord, in any way we've eaten what you have commanded us not to eat, like Eve ate the fruit and gave to Adam, in any way we have taken what you have not given to us, let mercy prevail over judgment. In the name of Jesus we have prayed. Amen. You will say, Father, be our sufficiency in our national life in the name of Jesus. Lord, supply all our needs according to your riches in glory. Lord, in our national life, we plead that you will meet all our needs. And Lord Jesus, we pray that you will block every loophole, every drainages, where all our needs that you have supplied have been stolen, have been drained away. Block them in the name of Jesus. Pray for yourself that God will meet you at the point of your needs according to his word in Philippians 4:19. All the needs of your life, everything that you need that pertains to life and godliness that God has given to you, you will begin to receive them physically. You begin to enjoy them in your life and in your family. In the name of the Lord Jesus, we have prayed. Amen. Say, Father, help every citizen of our nation to depend on you for their provision in the name of Jesus. Lord, we will lift up our eyes to the hills, from whence cometh our help. Our help cometh from the Lord which made heaven and earth. Lord Jesus, help our eyes to be fixed on you for our provisions. Lord, vain is the help of man. Vain is the help of the government. Vain is the help of mortal men like us. Lord, our eyes are on you. Please meet and supply every need In the name of Jesus, we pray, oh God, for all the citizens of this nation. Let them realize that you are the only true source of help and provision. In the name of Jesus, let our eyes be on you to meet and supply every need. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. You will say, Father, please bring Nigeria out of lack into abundance. Let Nigeria experience a change for good in the name of Jesus. Let the seasons of lack, of penury, of poverty, of insufficiency be over in this nation. Lord, bring Nigeria out of every form of penury, out of every form of lack in the name of Jesus. And let us begin to experience a change for good in this nation in the name of Jesus. We have been so much blessed with natural resources and everything we need for everyone to live in affluence. Lord, we pray that you will bring us out of seasons of lack and poverty. Change the time for good for us, for this nation and her citizens in the name of Jesus. God will change the tide for your good. It will supply all your needs. He will send help to you from above in the name of Jesus. You will no longer live in lack and want. God will transform your life for good and supply every need of your life. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Father, please see Nigeria through these times of difficulty and bring us to our promised land in the name of Jesus. Lord, as you arose for the children of Israel, you brought them out of the land of bondage. You brought them out of the land of captivity into a wealthy place with abundance, with riches, with gold, with silver. Lord, the same way, arise for Nigeria and bring us out of every season of lack, out of every season of difficulty. In the name of Jesus, Lord, deliver this nation from recession, from backwardness. Lord, everything that has to be done from the top to the bottom, by your mighty hand, the same way you deliver the children of Israel from the hands of the Egyptians, by your mighty hand, Father, do for us as a people, as a nation, in the name of Jesus, for you and your family, by the mighty hand of God, you are brought out of the land of bondage, of captivity, of lack and poverty. You will begin to walk in your wealthy place, begin to enjoy the wealth and divine inheritances that God had prepared for you. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen. You will say, Father, you are merciful, Father. Please help Nigeria to overcome all challenges of lack and want in the name of Jesus. You are the merciful Father. We plead and we ask. You will help this nation to come out of every season of lack and want and penury in the name of Jesus. Father, be merciful on us. Help us to overcome every challenge of lack, every challenge of insufficiency and not enough. In the name of Jesus, Lord, bring us out by your mighty power. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Please remember to comment a big amen in the comment section below and then like this video so that others can join us to pray this prayer. You will say, Father, just as you did for our nation when all hopes were lost during the Civil War, please surprise Nigeria again in the name of Jesus. Arise, O God, for Nigeria. As you arose in the days of the Civil War, you quelled the war. Lord, you stemmed the tide of the war for Nigeria to continue to move, to be together. Also, O God, arise again for this nation in the midst of the troublous, challenging, and difficult times that we are in. Jesus, arise and deliver this nation. Bring us into a season of peace, of rest, of progress, of prosperity, of increase, of abundance. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen. You will say, Father, by your divine power, move Nigeria forward in the name of Jesus. Forward ever, backward never for Nigeria. Father, by your divine power, move Nigeria forward progressively from glory to glory. Move Nigeria in the name of Jesus. Deliver us from retrogression and setbacks in the name of Jesus. Lord, deliver this nation in the name of Jesus from setbacks. Move us forward by your divine power in the name of Jesus. Father, we have no power of our own. We cry to you, please bring rest to Nigeria in the name of Jesus. We have no power of our own. We have no power of our own. Holy Spirit, we look up to you. Help us. We have no power of our own. Father, bring Nigeria out of every lack, out of every bondage in the name of Jesus. Lord, bring us into a place of rest, into our season of rest in the name of Jesus. Your word says in Matthew chapter 11 verse 28 that your yoke is easy and your burden is light. Father, we pray that every yoke on this nation shall be destroyed and you will bring us into your rest. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. I command rest on your life, rest on every side for you, in your going out, in your coming in your place of work, amongst your relatives, in your neighborhood, in your home. Let the rest of God rest upon you. You have rest spiritually, physically, emotionally, financially, in your health. You will be full of rest. Rest will be your portion in the name of Jesus. We pray. Amen. You will say, Father, open the windows of heaven over Nigeria for the sake of the elect. In the name of Jesus, for the sake of the elect who believe in the giving of their tithe and offering according to Malachi chapter 3 verse 10, Father, open the windows of heaven concerning Nigeria. Pour down your blessing upon us as a people in the name of Jesus and give us the wisdom to manage the blessing. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Father, let the season of harvest begin in Nigeria. In the name of Jesus, Lord, let the season of harvest begin in this nation. See the time and harvest will not cease according to your word in Genesis 8:22. Let the season of harvest begin in this nation. In the mighty name of Jesus, Most High God, we pray that you will take us out of the season of want and lack into our season of abundance of harvest. In the mighty name of Jesus, as this year is coming to an end, God will bring you into your season of harvest. In the name of Jesus, Isaac sowed in the land that same year. The Bible says he had an 100-fold return and God blessed him there. According to Genesis 26:12, God will bless you this year. It will prosper the work of your hands. You will harvest all your seed sown in the past. The one sown in tears, in joy, in all seasons, in the name of Jesus. The remaining days of this year, 35 more days to go, will be days of harvest for you, will be days of testimonies for you. In the name of the Lord Jesus, all your needs will be met. This end of the year will be the best in your lifetime. In the name of the Lord Jesus, we are prayed. Amen. Arise and let the oppressors of Nigeria begin to eat their own flesh and be drunken with their own blood as wine in the name of Jesus. Every oppressor of this nation, everyone siphoning the resources of this nation to themselves, stealing from this nation with impunity. Father, let them be drunken with their blood as of a sweet wine, and let them be fed with their flesh in the name of Jesus. If they refuse to repent, Lord, oppress the oppressors. Let their wealth oppress them. Let their blood oppress them. Let their water oppress them. Everything that they are enjoying now begin to oppress them. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. You say, Father, arise and overturn, overturn, and overturn until the oppressors are no more in Nigeria. According to your word in Ezekiel chapter 21 verse 27, Lord, arise and overturn, and overturn, and overturn the oppressors in this nation. Displace them out of their places. Chase them out of their hidden places. Lord, terrify them. Strike fear into their hearts in the name of Jesus. Lord, let there be a transfer of wealth, overturn and overturn until it comes to the turn of who it belongs to, that the citizens of this nation, the commonwealth of this nation, will be for the benefit of the citizens of this nation. You will eat the good of this land. You'll be a partaker of the blessings of God in this nation. In the mighty name of Jesus, everyone oppressing you, resisting you where you have been planted by God, God will overturn them for you, and God will put you in your rightful place and position. In the name of Jesus, we are prayed. Amen. You will say, Father, for your sake, arise and deliver the economy of Nigeria from the hands of the wicked. For the sake of your name, O God, God of Israel, God of Nigeria, God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, God of the redeemed Christian Church of God, the covenant keeping God, God of Papa Iya Deboye, arise, O God, for your name's sake, and deliver the economy of this nation. Let the seasons and the era of hardship be over. Let the season of ease and comfort, abundance and prosperity, Lord, manifest for every citizen of this nation. In the name of Jesus, the season of abundance will manifest for you and your family. Even in this nation, you will eat the good of this land. The economy of this nation will favor you. When people are saying there is a casting down, what you will be saying is there is a lifting up. I command that season to manifest for you in the name of Jesus. Amen. You say, Father, arise and completely destroy both internal and external oppressors of Nigeria. In the name of Jesus, every enemy within and without of this nation, arise, O God, destroy them and their plot. In the mighty name of Jesus, Lord, every of their evil agenda to keep this nation in oppression at whatever level, at the government level, at economic level, political level, Lord, arise and oppress the oppressors. Push them out of their places of power. Disgrace them, ridicule them. Everyone, O God, that has constituted a problem, an oppression to this nation, Lord, either internal or external, expose them, disgrace them, and let their memory be wiped off completely. Let peace reign for your people. Let the righteous rule. Let faithful men and women reign in this nation to further the agenda of heaven for the majority. In Jesus' name we are prayed. Amen. Father, dethrone and arrest every evil political leader that is enthroned for the purpose of enslaving citizens. In the name of Jesus, Father, dethrone and arrest every political leader that has been enthroned to enslave citizens of this nation. Everyone in political office, using their offices to oppress the masses, using their offices to oppress the unhelped people, the hopeless people, the helpless people. Father, fight against those political leaders and raise faithful leaders who may not be politicians. Raise them wherever they are in different sectors to be voices for the voiceless, to be hope for the hopeless, to be help for the helpless, to be eyes for the blind, to be hands for those whose hands are withered. Lord, we pray that you will raise men and women that would displace wicked political leaders in this nation. And Lord, let the commonwealth of this nation be available for all citizens in the name of Jesus. We pray. Amen. And finally, you say, Father, in the name of Jesus, remove evil representatives from all our leadership positions in the name of Jesus. Father, remove every evil representative from all our leadership positions in this nation. Everyone representing the devil, representing darkness as tyrants and oppressors, wicked men and women in high places. Lord, remove them, dethrone them, eliminate them, uproot them in the name of Jesus. Let righteousness reign in our nation. Thank you, Heavenly Father, for divine provisions, for divine assistance for our lives and for this nation. Lord, we will come back testifying that the remaining days of this year will be the best so far for us, that all our needs will be met. In Jesus' mighty name we are praying. Amen. Say a big amen. Amen. Thank you very much for joining us to pray these prayers today. Please like the video so that others can see and also pray with us, and share with your friends and family. See you again tomorrow if Jesus tarries. God bless you.